Hello ladies and gentlemen, this is Mr. TARDIS. Now, I was halfway through editing my review of Bad Wolf, and then I saw this news story, and I just could not continue editing until I made some sort of video or statement about this. Now, last night was the Hugo Awards, and the main Doctor Who-themed award for the Hugos is the Short Form Dramatic Presentation Award. And to qualify for this, the work must be less than 90 minutes long, excluding commercials. And the short form award is for a dramatized production in any medium, including film, television, radio, live theater, computer games, or music. But mainly it goes to, this is where television or some animated short films get nominated. And Doctor Who has had great success with the Hugo Awards since it came back in 2005. The first year it was nominated was for Series 1, where Dalek, Father's Day and The Empty Child and the Doctor Dances were nominated. And that year The Empty Child and the Doctor Dances won the Hugo Award. In fact, they even beat Pixar, who that same year entered Jack-Jack Attack, which was The Incredibles short film. So that's a great accomplishment, and those nominees were very deserving nominees. Dalek, Father's Day, and The Empty Child and the Doctor Dances are some of the best stories of that season, so very deserving nominees. For the year afterwards, the nominated stories were School Reunion, The Girl in the Fireplace, and Army of Ghosts / Doomsday. Once again, three great stories, some of the best that season had to offer, and a very deserving win from Stephen Moffat, once again for The Girl in the Fireplace. Year after, we didn't have as many nominees, but we still won that year. Doctor Who Blink won, so once again, another Stephen Moffat script, and also a nomination was Human Nature and the Family of Blood, and also another nominee was Torchwood Season 1 for Captain Jack Harkness, which was a pretty damn good piece of television. So once again, we had some success. The year afterwards was the first year that that Doctor Who didn't win. Instead, the winner was Dr. Horrible's sing-along blog, where Joss Whedon took the award for that. I've not seen it, but I've heard incredibly good things, so I'm just going to assume it was a worthy win. But the nominees that year for Doctor Who was Silence in the Library / Forest of the Dead, another Stephen Moffat script, and Doctor Who Turn Left, two very deserving nominees again. Then the year afterwards, the nominees were kind of questionable. Doctor Who won again for Doctor Who The Waters of Mars. Once again, that was a very deserving win. Waters of Mars was the best Doctor Who special, in my opinion. But the nominees were The Next Doctor and Planet of the Dead. Okay, The Next Doctor is a pretty poor story, and Planet of the Dead is average at absolute best, so you'd figure that if any story got nominated, it would be The End of Time, because it was considered, even if it wasn't that good, it was considered an event story, and there were some fantastic moments in it. But instead, no, the next Doctor was what got nominated. Okay, that's kind of weird. But the year after, things went back to form, with The Pandorica Opens with the Big Bang, another Stephen Moffat script winning. Also, the nominees were A Christmas Carol. Okay, that's a pretty poor nomination, but also another nominee was Vincent and the Doctor, very deserving, and to be honest, it's got a lot of other awards, so it's okay that one didn't win, in my opinion. Then the year afterwards was probably the best in terms of the quality of the stories that got nominated. The Doctor's Wife won, the Neil Gaiman script, but also were the ones that got nominated were The Girl Who Waited and A Good Man Goes to War. The three best stories of Series 6 got nominated, which was fantastic. But this year, it seems to have gone in the complete opposite direction. So the nominees this year were Doctor Who Asylum of the Daleks by Stephen Moffat, Doctor Who The Angels Take Manhattan by Stephen Moffat, and Doctor Who The Snowmen by Stephen Moffat. And the other two nominees were Game of Thrones Blackwater by George R.R. Martin, who wrote the original novels and the screenplay for the story, and Fringe Letters of Transit by J.J. Abrams, bleh, Alex Kurtzman, Roberto Orci, Akivi Goldsman, J.H. Wyman, Jeff Pinkner, lots of writers. But the winner this year was Game of Thrones Blackwater. Now, Game of Thrones, I have not watched, but I've heard nothing but great things about it. At university, I had many, many friends who loved Game of Thrones and would worship it absolutely. They loved the show. and I know that it's become this massive cultural thing. So whether or not Game of Thrones deserved to win is not my place to say, but all I can say is that Doctor Who did not deserve to win this year with those three nominees. Now, this is Doctor Who's 50th anniversary. So when people look back, this is going to be a very important year for the programme. It's already disappointing that Doctor Who was hardly on top form this year. In fact, in my opinion, Series 7 is the weakest series since Doctor Who came back in 2005. Well, it's either Series 6 or Series 7 are the weakest. No, Series 2 is the weakest. But Series 6 or 7 are a very close second. But these nominees are just... I'm sorry, but Asylum of the Daleks and the Snowmen are unmitigated pieces of shit, and The Angels Take Manhattan, the only good thing that that episode did was Amy and Rory's departure, and even then that wasn't so well handled. And all three of those are written by Stephen Moffat, so I think that the Hugo Awards Committee, who choose the nominees and the winners, just love Stephen Moffat, so they thought, oh, we won't even watch the episodes, we'll just put these episodes in because he was written by them, so he's written winners before, so he must be good. But no, I think that it really says something that the nominees for the Hugo Awards, which is supposed to be the absolute best in television, were nominated to the three Doctor Who stories that were the absolute weakest of this respective year. In fact, the only way this could get worse was that if instead of Fringe getting nominated, we had another Doctor Who script nominated, Journey to the Center of the TARDIS, which, looking back, I think was the second worst episode of the series. The worst one was Asylum of the Daleks, because that was just... oh my god. But Journey to the Center of the TARDIS is a close second. And it's... oh my goodness. These three nominees, Asylum of the Daleks, Angels Take Manhattan, and The Snowmen, those are very poor pieces of television. And the fact that they were Doctor Who's representation for the Hugos, in other words, saying, this is what we think the best that Doctor Who has to offer, these are the nominees, is just such a disservice to the programme in such an integral year. I don't think Doctor Who's output has been especially good this year, but the best stories were Dinosaurs on a Spaceship and The Rings of Akaten and arguably Cold War. And those three aren't the ones to get nominated. Instead, it's the three worst by the exact same writer. And to be honest, Doctor Who did not deserve to win this year with that sort of output. And Game of Thrones or Fringe, probably not Fringe, because I've not heard that great things about it. And you know, it's J.J. Abrams, so you know it's not going to be especially good. So Game of Thrones was pretty much the winner by default here. I don't really have that much more to say, except the moral of the story is that if you want awards recognition, Stephen Moffat, you actually have to write good stories instead of pieces of absolute crap like Asylum of the Daleks and the Snowmen. Okay, rant over. Very sorry that I just had to quickly make this video and rant about it. But I shall see you guys next time